In a healthy cell, the NOD-like receptor called NALP3, also known as NLRP3, resides in the cytoplasm as a monomer. NALP3 has a pyrin domain at its amino terminus and a domain of leucine-rich repeats, also known as the LRR domain. Under normal physiological conditions, the LRR domain associates with cellular chaperone proteins that include the heat shock protein 90, or HSP90. When cells are injured or put under stress, the integrity of the plasma membrane can be compromised, and potassium cations can leak from the cytoplasm. For reasons that aren't exactly clear, the efflux of potassium from the cell triggers a dissociation of HSP90 with the LLR domain of NALP3 and produces a free monomer of NALP3 in the cytoplasm. Free monomers of NALP3 are able to form dimers. In a manner reminiscent of TLR signaling, the dimerization of NALP3 brings the two pyrin domains into close proximity with one another. In this orientation, the pyrin domains of NALP3 serve as an efficient recruitment platform to attract and bind an adapter protein called PICARD. The adapter protein PICARD resides in the cytoplasm in association with an inactive form, or proenzyme, of caspase 1. PICARD associates with pro-caspase 1 through the interactions between their CARD domains. In this conformation, pro-caspase 1 is maintained in an inactive state. When PICARD is recruited to the NALP3 dimer, their conformations are altered. At the same time, pro-caspase 1 molecules are brought into close proximity with one another. In this orientation and close proximity, one molecule of pro-caspase 1 is able to cleave a nearby molecule of pro-caspase 1. This cleavage results in an active caspase 1 molecule, which in turn can then cleave other pro-caspase 1 molecules. This complex of NALP3, PICARD, and pro-caspase 1 is called the NALP3 inflammasome, and its activation leads to the generation of active caspase 1. Active caspase 1 molecules attack the inactive pro-protein forms of the cytokines IL-beta and IL-18 that reside in the cytoplasm. Activated caspase 1 cleaves these inactive proforms and releases the active cytokines. The active cytokines are subsequently released from the cell and exert pro-inflammatory actions on nearby lymphocytes.